Coronavirus has helped us put life into jarring perspective. Our society is apparently mainly defined by being able to eat out, go to bars, and buy and sell stuff. Even in lockdown, we can still eat a lot, drink, and buy and sell stuff, but apparently that isn't enough. Some of the modifications we've made now should surely remain in place forever. And I say that on behalf of the herds of elk who have returned to wander the Oregon coastline and bathe in the eddies between the sandbars, the monkeys who swim unmolested now in abandoned hotel pools in Mumbai, the bulls who are now spared slipping and sliding and breaking a leg or two before being tortured to death in Pamplona, and the horses who are peacefully grazing rather than being pumped full of performance-enhancing drugs at the racetrack. The air is cleaner now, the pace is more relaxed, and with human ingenuity, I know that we can find other ways to look after those who are less well off than ourselves and start respecting the natural world. For now, the goats and the deer who are venturing out to graze on lawns that were once their ancestral homelands, and the bears and the lions in parks in other parts of the world, welcome our lockdown. What an indictment. Perhaps when we again have the chance to live as we please, to go where we wish, we can modify our greed and dress and buy things and entertain ourselves without harming others. Let's not be quick to celebrate the return of commerce and our freedom. We must be more aware of the consequences of what we do so casually, but which affects others so mightily. And emerge from this pandemic as moral agents, kinder and more aware of how our lives impact those whose world we reduce, and those who have been forced into the margins.